Hello, it's a lovely good evening from here in Delhi, and hope that each one of you are absolutely fine. And that's what we always wish for and pray for your good health, for your cheerful, what we call energetical mood. And we hope that each one of you are in the best of the what we call health. So now starting the today's proceedings with the chapter that is known as electricity, and this particular chapter lots of requests I have been receiving to start, and so today is the what we call day when we have decided to take up this particular chapter. So if you are ready, then we on our side are absolutely ready. But before we start this particular chapter, let me make it absolutely clear, as you must have heard and you are aware of by now actually, that earlier, as far as this particular chapter was concerned, electricity, accounts of electricity company, this chapter was covered under Electricity Act 1910. Then there was Electricity Supply Act of 1948. There were the electricity rules of 1956. But this particular chapter has gone a sea change in the sense that now it has been replaced by Electricity Act 2003. So lots of changes have taken place, so this particular chapter has been now completely revamped, and that is the reason actually that you will have to pay a little bit extra focus. So picking up, we are today, first of all, electricity accounting, no doubt about that, but first of all we are going to have a lot of discussion with respect to the theoretical aspect, and then we shall move into the practical part, correct? So we start electricity. Just pay attention, electricity, we are starting today's this particular session. First, let me write electricity. Accounts of electricity company, correct? So, Electricity Act 2003, Electricity Act 2003, let me actually just first of all change the color of the ink. Electricity Act 2003 has been enacted to replace, as I said, what? To replace a Indian Electricity Act of 1910, correct? Then B, Electricity Supply Act 1948, Electricity Act 1948, correct? Then C, Electricity Rules 1956. Electricity Rules 1956. So Electricity Act 2003 has been introduced to replace what we call these acts. Besides, it has also replaced Electricity Electricity Regulatory Commissions Act of 1998. So first of all, you should be aware of this particular fact, that the present act, Electricity Act, as I've already told you, this particular act has been enacted recently, and it has replaced what we call these acts, correct? Then what is the objective of what we call Electricity Act 2003? We will see. Actually, the main objective is to consolidate the laws which are related to generation, distribution and transmission of electricity. In the earlier acts, it was felt that there were many flaws and many deficiencies and many drawbacks. So basically, we wanted to actually erase it out, and that was the reason. In fact, that was the demand of the time also, that a new act should come. So it was enacted, and the basic intention is to actually take measures for the conducive development of industry and providing what we call enough competition. You must have noticed earlier, as far as field of electricity was concerned, that was completely dominated by the government companies. But now, even the private players have come into the competition, into the fray. So that is why the one of the idea behind enacting this particular act was to actually provide some competition. So when there will be some competition, of course, we know that then things actually takes a better shape. Then, of course, another intention behind what we call to enact this particular act was to protect the interest of the consumers with respect to the supply of electricity to almost all the areas. So these are the major, what we call, these are the major objectives. So we should be aware of that. So you have to write along with me then. Right, objectives. Objectives. Objectives A, to consolidate, as I said, to consolidate the laws, to consolidate the laws relating to consolidate the laws relating to generation comma transmission comma distribution comma trading and use of electricity. So one of the objective is to consolidate, to make the law a little bit what we call more stern with respect to generation, transmission and distribution of distribution and trading and use of electricity. Correct? Then B, I will take the help of the next sheet. Right. B, you write, to take measures to take measures for conducive development of industry and promoting competition I'm writing in actually today laptop that is no actually along with that there is Wacom. So sometime you cannot actually reflect your natural handwriting because it is very difficult to write on it. So that is the reason most of you who among you are actually accustomed to my normal handwriting, they might be feeling, sir, what happened to your handwriting? So anyway, competition, correct? C, it was point number B, and now we are moving over to point number C, correct? Point number C, to protect interest of consumers and supply of electricity and supply of electricity to all the areas So it was another objective. Then point number D. Correct. rationalize tariff, electricity tariff. Tariff means the charge which the electricity company charge from the consumer. So here the government will not give the freedom and the liberty to the electricity company to have a blood-sucking attitude of the consumer. So they will have to actually put their tariff as per the parameters which are set out by the government. That means, in simple words, we will not allow the electricity company to charge excessive tariff. They will have to follow the rules and the regulation enacted by the government. That is what we mean by rationalize what we call tariff. We are not going to give them what we call enough room to manipulate that tariff according to their own wishes and aspirations. Then, E, ensure transparent policies regarding subsidies. Ensure transparent policies regarding subsidies. Now, you should have a little bit of idea that these are the major objectives which I have just mentioned. Now, the another important point is that you should be aware of which are the regulatory, what we call authorities under the new Electricity Act. So, writing I am here, various regulatory authorities under Electricity Act. A, Central Electricity Authority. B, appropriate commissions. Like CERC. CERC means Central Electricity Regulatory Commission, correct? Just for knowledge sake, actually I'm writing comma SERC. SERC means State Electricity Regulatory Commission, correct? So, as far as regulatory authorities are concerned, one will be Central Electricity Authority. Name itself actually signifies that this particular authority will be responsible for all the what we call objectives, to achieve the objectives which have been enacted under the Electricity Act 2003 overall, because it is Central Electricity Authority. Whereas appropriate commissions, basically they are more what we call responsible for the development of these objectives in the state rather than overall. Is it clear to you or not? Then we shall write license requirement under Electricity Act. As far as license requirement is considered, the first point is that no license No license is required. Correct. I'll move over to the next sheet. Should I? Written. Well, now I can move over to the next slide. So no license is required for power generation except for hydro projects over a certain size. So the first point is important, that no license requirement is there as far as generation of power is concerned. But at the same time, if you are going to generate hydro power projects in that particular place, you may require what we call license. Correct. Now, next point, point number B. No person shall A. No person shall transmit, distribute, or undertake trading unless authorized to do so. That is, should have the license. So logically speaking, no what we call license requirement is there for power generation, but at the same time, if you are interested in generating hydropower, you need what we call license. Also, you need license if you are interested in what we call transmitting or distributing, as I said, or what we call trading of electricity. In that particular case, license requirement is mandatory. So this was the initial theoretical part. Now we shall have some discussion with respect to, as I said, what we call accounting part. Correct. Now we move over to accounting part, and in the accounting part, first of all, let me write accounting. Now we are coming over to the accounting part. Correct. Accounting. So under accounting, point number one, you write here, point number one, accounting for security deposits received by electricity companies. Here, very important point. See, actually, you presume yourself an electricity company, so you sometime receive the security deposit from the consumer or from the industries or from those fellows to whom you are going to actually supply the electricity, isn't it or not? Suppose if I have to take the electricity connection today, I will have to deposit some amount with the electricity company, isn't it or not? So that is the reason why I'm telling actually. It is seen that electricity company actually, they generally what we call take, as I said, was some amount as security deposit. So what will be the accounting treatment with respect to that? That is the important point. We are more interested in that because now slowly and steadily we have already moved over to the accounting. Now we are trying to grasp some important significant points with respect to the accounting as far as Electricity Act 2003 is concerned. Correct? So in order to comprehend this, actually I'm taking one example first. In fact, example one. In this example, I will try to explain the accounting treatment as far as security deposit which the electricity company would receive from which the electricity company receives what we call against supply of electricity connection or other facilities to consumers or industries. Correct? Right here, X4, an electricity distribution company took 100 lakhs as security deposits from its consumers on 1/7/2014. If you have written, let me move over to the next slide. Then write. We have written that X4 electricity company, a distribution company, isn't it or not, took what we call some amount, that is 100 lakhs as security deposit from the consumers. And you write one more thing, RBI rate on 1/4/2014 is 7%. When we are going to pay some amount as security deposit to the electricity company is supposed to what we call pay some interest on that amount to the consumers or from all those institutions, industries or consumers from whom it has taken the amount of security deposit. Correct? So how that is accounted, that is the basic idea behind doing this particular question. So now we do the solution. As far as solution is concerned, first of all, you presume yourself that you are the electricity company, because so often I have told you that whenever we do accounting, actually, it is always better to presume as yourself the accountant of the concern from the perspective of which accounting is being done. So this term accounting is being done from the perspective of, as I said, what we call electricity company. So if If you are means electricity company. If electricity company would receive security deposit, you will receive some cash, and it's a liability. Remember one thing: security deposit is a liability from the perspective of electricity company. So your first entry will be on 1st of 7, because this is the date on which you receive the amount of security deposit, isn't it or not? So your entry will be bank account debit. How much you have received? You have received 100 lakhs. Two, security deposit account. You write to security deposit, 100 lakhs. Correct? Bank security deposit receipt. Amount of security deposit received. Now we will reach the end of the first accounting year. First accounting year of electricity company, let's say, is ending on 31st of 3 2015. You received the security on 1st of July, end of the accounting year, because generally electricity companies, they have financial year as their accounting year. Their accounting year must have begun on 1st of April 2014, and now they have reached the end of the accounting year 31st 3 2015. So first of all, now you need to compute actually how much time has elapsed since 1st of July. So if I'm going to compute the time period from 1st of July 2014 till what we call 31st 3 2015, it will be equal to 9 months. Is it clear to you? So it means now the electricity company is supposed to pay interest to the person from whom it has taken the security deposit, isn't it or not? So 9 months interest it will not pay. First of all, you must understand, it will not pay the interest, but interest will become due on this date. So my entry will be interest expense account debit. Interest expense will be debited, and I will write here too, interest accrued on security deposit. Amount of security deposit is 100 lakhs. Rate of interest is 7%, and we have to compute the interest for 9 months. So it will be equal to 5,25,000. So 5,25,000, 5,25,000. This is the entry which you are going to make. Is it clear to you or not? This is the entry, as I said, you are supposed to make in this particular question. Is it clear? Absolutely clear, that's fine. So if it is clear, then great to have that. Now we move over to the next part. Now see here what is happening. Now I will move into the next year. Next year means 15 and 16, and now I am going to write end of first quarter, or you simply write Q1. Q1 means first quarter. Electricity Act says, now please try to pay attention. You are the electricity company, and you were supposed to pay the interest. And interest was 5,25,000. You didn't pay the interest yet. Try to understand this point. Correct? You were supposed to pay the interest, but you passed the entry for interest due. You did not pay the interest. The reason is that because you know that ultimately you are going to receive some amount, because we consumers are supposed to pay every month, or let us say every alternate month, some amount for using the electricity to the electricity company. Isn't it or not? Try to understand this point actually. Just wait for a while. Don't write. This is the rough work. Electricity company, as I said, electricity company charges from the consumer every month, you know, some amount. Every month we are supposed to pay electricity bill, and nowadays we are paying very high amount of electricity bill, isn't it or not? It means electricity company will receive something from the consumer. The electricity company, which it receives something from the consumer, technically known as what we call charges for supplying the electricity. So you being the consumer, you will pay some amount to electricity company because you are using the electricity, isn't it or not? So that amount from the perspective of the electricity company is nothing but revenue. First of all, you must understand, it is, you presume electricity company as a seller, and it is charging something from the consumer, and whatever we charge, that is revenue. So now electricity company, what it will do, instead of paying this interest, it will adjust this interest against your electricity bill. Are you getting my point? Suppose electricity company is supposed to pay you 5,25,000 as interest, correct? But your electricity bill is, let us say, rupees 6 lakh. So electricity company will simply ask you to pay what we call 75,000 only. Are you getting my point? Instead of the fact that electricity company should pay you 5,25,000 and receive what we call 6 lakh against the same, electricity company will simply ask you to pay 75,000. That is what my point is. So electricity company is not going to pay you the interest. Electricity company is simply ask you, you pay the difference. Is it clear to you or not? So this is how, this is the rough work. Remember one thing, and I'm going to erase it out. See here, it takes time to erase. So now the position is like this. Let me move back. Yes. Now electricity company will make the adjustment. And remember one thing, this adjustment will be made as per the electricity regulations in the first quarter of the next year. The current year was 14 and 15. Next year is 15 and 16. So in the first quarter, when we say first quarter, quarter is of 3 months. An accounting year 15-16 will begin on 1st of April. That means this adjustment technically is being made on 30th of June 2015. Correct? And what will be what we call my entry? My entry will be, I am going to adjust this interest accrued against the revenue. So my entry will be interest accrued on security deposit. Interest accrued on security deposit to revenue account. So it will be adjusted against the electricity bill which the electricity company would receive from the consumer. Now the consumer will have to pay only the difference amount, difference which, in case if there will be any. So 5,25,000 will be adjusted against the revenue. This is how the accounting for security deposit and interest on security deposit is done. Is it clear to you or not? Your narration will be adjustment of interest accrued on security deposit against sales revenue. So you are going to adjust it against the sales revenue. Is it clear to you or not? Not a very tough task. It's a very simple. Whatever amount you are going to receive as security, you will pass the entry bank account debit to security deposit account, number one. Now you compute the interest charges. That is, as you simply compute outstanding charges, we call it interest accrued on security deposit. It is a liability from the point of view of, remember one thing, electricity company. And electricity company will adjust this liability, not in cash, rather against the amount which it is supposed to receive from the what we call consumer, and it is known as revenue. So it will be adjusted against the revenue. That's all, nothing more, nothing tough in it. Very simple, isn't it or not? Now we move over to the next accounting part, correct? Next accounting part that deals with point number two. Second, capital, service line, what happens? Just wait. Sometime it happens. Okay, we will continue in the next session, correct? Right now we are stopping it here, but we are going to continue it in the next session. Just wait for a while. Just wait, we are trying to continue. Actually, just electricity sometime plays a little bit of trouble. So we come back, we'll still continue. Actually, in between what happens sometime, power plays a little bit of problem, so, correct? So capital, service line, contributions, we shall talk about, but we shall talk about it in the next session, correct? So we can begin the next session in a better manner.